I don't know, I've just got a different sort of angle when I was setting up, so apologies for the shabbiness of this affair, but I hope you're doing really well. Tonight we're doing another sort of ramble, sort of story time. I mentioned in the story time that I did, I suppose when you're seeing this, a couple of days ago, about like the garage house fire thing, that was actually going to be part of like a series of sort of like mini stories to tell you, but I realised that, well, it ended up being like a 20 odd minute tale, so I broke it down into its own video, and I mentioned I had a few sort of holiday stories that could be quite interesting to sort of listen to. I know we've been doing a lot of ramble videos recently. Personally, I love ramble videos. I think it's in part due to me having I prefer the term inquisitive personality. But it's more of a proclivity to sort of nosiness and gossip. So I don't know what this is new. No idea if it's relaxing or adding to the affair, but yes we are going to be doing a whisper ramble, talking about some stories of when I was on holiday as a kid and stuff that happened on those holidays that were kind of mental, not massively mental, but just something to go, well, that's unfortunate, or that's weird. And, you know, and hopefully along the way, there are some chuckles, and helps you relax, something like that. You know, that's the aim of the game here, on the channel, relaxo-dainment. That's the aim, and that's the aim. Also a coffee and cake video, so which I think could be a cool new sort of series, kind of like a tale with an ale, ramble with a beer, but a new one, coffee and a cake, coffee and a cake. So as always with our coffee, we have a nice hot mug. Nice and hot. And for the cake, we have just a small little treat. A Mr. Kipling. Mr. Kipling. Lemon slice. Chilling. to, like, you know, hang out and play with people our age. And yeah, one day I'd befriended this group. So I was only 4 years old. I was 4 years old, and there's pretty much similar ages up to about maybe 8. And like on the days like we weren't in the club, you'd like see them around the building and hang out. And one day, when I was hanging out with this other kid that I hung out with, we merged with this other big group who had this massive Lilo, like it's really, really big Lilo. I'm assuming you guys know what Lilo is, you know, the big plastic sort of like lounges that you have in the pool, so you can lie on, you can lie low. So they had one of these really long ones, and they took it up to the top of this really big slide. And somehow, I still don't quite know how this was allowed. I know it was 2002, but we all got on this massive Lilo, so there's maybe 8 of us, maybe. So there was like 4 on the Lilo, 2 in sort of front, and then there's 2 at the back. I was at the back sort of holding on. So imagine it's this Mr. Kipling slice. 2 at the front. 4 on top. 2 at the back. Sort of like hanging off it. We go down this slide. And you go into this pool. Obviously, at the end of the slide is a pool. And when we landed there, I went under the Lilo, so back to the Mr. Kipling slice. I went like that, so my feet sort of got dragged under, and I was stuck under this Lilo, which had 2 people on it, and people like thrashing around, you know, as you get off the pool, and I couldn't get my head up, and I was down for like a good minute, and I was panicking and panicking. Until I got dragged. Unfortunately, I got dragged out. Because I was just, honestly, it was like, I don't have obviously a vivid recollection of it as I was 4 years old. But yeah, that's actually one of my only real memories of that holiday. But remember being like sort of trapped under this big plastic sheet. And I was like, this isn't ideal. So yeah, that was St. Lucia's. That was my first holiday. Apart from that, though, it was a brilliant holiday. You know, when you're a kid, as long as there's a pool, and I really wish people would stop shutting the ruddy doors. You know, you're having a great time, aren't you? So, that's twice that door is just shut. It's like, shut it the first time properly. So, here we have the Mr. Kipling slice. Tasty, tasty, tasty. Nice and quite refreshing, the sort of lemon zest, lemony, zesty. So the next holiday, that involved a pretty crazy incident. I say pretty crazy, I'm stretching the term there, but something happened that was injurious. It was, I think for my birthday, we went to Disneyland Paris. So, I think at this point I was about 6 years old. So, we went to Disneyland Paris. I think we took the Eurostar. I can't really remember the journey. I can't really remember much of it, really. I remember having like dinner one night, and there was like loads of chocolate mousse for dessert, and I remember that just being like the absolute dogs, you know, dogs go nuts. I was like, this is brilliant. And I don't actually remember much of the theme park. I remember we were staying in some sort of apartment, and I remember for my birthday I got like little toy knights. I really like, when I was a kid, I really liked, you know, playing with like toy soldiers. It was quite anachronistic because you could have military soldiers or like medieval knights and a bit like catapults and cannons and all that jazz. And so, but then one day we were going round, I think we'd just done the teacups. this ride because it looked really, really cool. Not that I was like a massive fan of Dumbo. I haven't really seen it to this day. But the ride just looked cool because you're on like Dumbo. And it was like going up and down, up and down, up and down. And so I, being ever the impatient person that I am, heightened a lot greater in the body of a six-year-old. That sounds weird out of context, but yeah, my impatience, I ran ahead of my family to get in the queue, so, and there was a sort of ramp that sort of snaked up to the ride, and I sprinted, and what I failed to see was that to assist the sort of queue system were ropes, like these quite thin blue ropes to sort of like pen you in. Now, they were only about waist high. Unfortunately, waist high for a six-year-old is at neck level. So I was running, I didn't see this rope, and I sort of like, I caught it on my neck. So I basically ran. I got clotheslined by a sort of some weird rope, garrotted myself essentially, flew backwards, right? Because I was going, I was sprinting full speed. Not exactly Usain Bolt, but you know, I was full out. Hit this rope, flew back, and apparently I was really lucky because I instinctively like put my hand out first and protected my head. Apparently could have been quite damaging. But the next thing I remembered after that was I was sort of sat on, like, away from the ride. I saw my mum and my two sisters on the ride, enjoying the ride. I was just with my dad. I think I got an ice cream. But I never did get to go on that ride. Yeah, that was a shame. Yeah, so like 2 in 2 holidays, like in my early years of life, and some sort of, you know, like, seriously, why? Had some sort of painful ramifications. Wait, it's nice. Sorry, my voice. It's a nice season. Something. I think, yeah, also slightly a little bit OCD as a young teenager. Like when I was in my old house, I'd constantly have to go downstairs and check that my garage door was locked and the lights were turned off, and I'd do that like 3, 4, 5 times before I could like sell and like go to sleep and stuff. And it's weird, but yeah. So we're on holiday. And then I was in a room on my own. The benefit of being the only son. The son and heir was graced with his own room. So I was just scratching the mattress, which is making some rather loud sound. And so one evening, I couldn't sleep, and for some reason I just felt something was off with the villa, because everywhere else was quiet, like there wasn't anyone really around us. And I looked outside. I decided to peer out of the sort of like the door, my door that led onto the sort of balcony. And I looked as well, I sort of looked through the blinds, you know, I sort of went like this, looked through the blinds, nothing. Look through the blinds again, nothing. I looked through the blinds again, and I saw a shadowy figure go past. Convinced I saw a shadow move. And, you know, the moment you get the slightest bit of something that could remotely confirm your suspicions, go into overdrive. So, I wake my mum and dad up. Again, they've never let this go, understandably. I went, "Dad, I've seen someone outside. I've seen someone outside." He's like, "What? What?" "And I've seen someone go past my bedroom window." Like, "My bedroom thing." "And what?" So he got up, calling me every name under the sun, went outside, looked. There was no one, obviously. Came in, he went, "Oh, yeah, just go to bed." So go back to bed. 5 minutes later, right, the villa alarm goes off. Right, so I've just mentioned this potential intruder, and then we all go back to bed. The alarm goes off, so ding, ding, ding. It wasn't like that, actually. It was more, I can't remember it, but I just remember going off. So we're awake again, and it's like, "What's that?" And I'm like, "I don't know, but, you know, don't just so." And again, there was no one there, so we turned it off. I had another little sort of look around and went, "Right, no one's there." And I'm like, "Well, I'm never going to sleep again." And so, yeah, we went back to bed again. And then it went off a second time. So we're all up again and going, "Right, this is mental. What is going on?" At that time, it turned out my dad hadn't sort of turned off the alarm. He just put it on some sort of like reset timer. So that was on him, that was on him. Yeah, that was the spookiest thing ever. Proper spooked me. And yeah, I'm 22. I'm now old enough to admit the embarrassing things I've done, you know. I spent the rest of the holiday sleeping in my mum and dad's room at sort of 12, 13 years old. I had moved my mattress in. That's the only way I could sleep, because I was petrified. So, wasn't always this cool, brave lad. But that was proper spooky. It was a fact that the alarm was going off. And as well, I remember, I think it was 2012, yeah, because I remember being absolutely petrified about the 2012 end of the world thing. That spooked me, so I had that on my mind as well. I was just like a bag of nerves at 13. Like, I was convinced like the world was gonna end. And I remember worrying about that in like 2011, so I'd like it. It was, yeah. But yeah, but the cool thing about the holiday, whilst I had the worst sleep and quite a frightful thing, I saw a shooting star for the first time, which was incredible. We were just sort of playing cards. Uno, I think. It's a card game, but it's not cards, is it? And yeah, I just saw a shooting star in the sky. That's pretty cool. But yeah, that's... I suppose they're the sort of crazy tales. Not really crazy tales, but just something to ramble about, really. Tales from holidays gone by. Fortunately, all the sort of holidays were relatively uneventful. Uneventful. Cheers. That's good, that. So yeah. It's just some coffee and cake and rambling. Sorry, again, you just heard some more instead of some rambling. Yeah, guys, I'll let you get off. I'm keeping you here against your will. But yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you all in the next video. So from me, guys, as always, it's lots of love, as always, my friends. It's a privilege to spend this time with you, and I wish you all the very, very best. So, lots of love.